Good morning. So you're outside, be warm, beautiful morning. And we're sitting as comfortably as you can, with as long a spine as you can. So a sense of rooting the pelvis down to what you're sitting in, taking a few deeper breaths, a few shrugs in the shoulders, just to feel the expansion of the ribcage, just to note what it feels like when it is full. And our practice in many ways is about tapping into that quality of fullness, you know, that sense of I am full, I am complete. And paradoxically, that fullness relies on our deeper sense of how we're connected to this life that we're woven through. And maybe even at this time, particularly at this time when so much of the external relationships that give us a sense of comfort or a sense of identity or fullness are hopefully temporarily pulled away. The invitation then is to turn inward. And this practice rests on the premise that we are complete, that we are full. So let's close our eyes and just notice. Notice the sounds. Notice your breath. Let the attention rest closely to your breath. Soften your jaw and your face. Your shoulders relax. Your belly. Staying with your breath. Now we inhale for a count of five and exhale for a count of five. The breath is slow and steady. Inhaling for five, and now pausing for three. Exhaling for five, pausing for three. And no part of the breath is pushed or forced. And in particular, soften the beginning of the exhalation. Stay with your breath. to continue with your breath, but drop the counting. So stay with the long, deep, comfortable breath. Stay with the pauses between the breath. And then after your next exhalation, return again to your natural breath. Stay with your breath. Mind wandering is perfectly normal. Each time you become aware that the mind has wandered, and gently come back to the breath. Let's do our 10 deep breaths now, either using the nose or the mouth. Deep inhalations from the base of the belly all the way up to the top of the chest. Effortless exhalation, 10 breaths. And as you finish your 10th exhalation, coming back to the natural breath and just noticing, observing how you feel. We'll go for the second round, 10 deep breaths. And you just let the sensations pass, those strong sensations that arise. So final round, if it's possible, we're going to do 20. But if you're more comfortable with 10, that's perfect also. So you get to choose. Deep breaths, easy exhales. And again, at the end of this final round, the end of the final longer exhalation, we'll pause without inhaling. For as long as that feels comfortable. Okay, we begin. And as you come back to your natural breath, let's bring the hands together in front of the heart. And the hands really represent this coming together of all those different parts of ourselves, all those fragmented parts, coming back into unified balance. And of course, all of us have stuff we need to be doing, maybe a little less at the moment, but so much of our life revolves around the doing, the day-to-day stuff. And it's a hugely important part of life. And yet, as many of us are experiencing, as we take this time to sit and to breathe and to be still, that we can infuse the movement of our lives, the dance of our lives, with something stiller, something quieter, something more profound. So our practice allowing us to drop a little deeper within ourselves, to hone our receptivity to the moment, this moment. And something in us begins to relax as we do that. Some internal struggle begins to quieten. So for a moment we think of gratitude. Maybe you remember the last time you felt it, or maybe you think about somebody. Maybe you just feel the feeling of it. You find that in yourself. And maybe we could be grateful simply for this moment. That we could be grateful for everything. And in a sense, grateful for nothing, having no need for anything to tune into this experience of gratitude. And then for a moment, we simply bow our heads. Beautiful. Good work, well done. I hope the practice is supporting you. You know, as you continue this practice, there are days where you'll definitely feel the benefits, some days you mightn't. But certainly as you continue to practice, it really begins to create a quality of foundation that really helps us be in the world. So I wish you a great day. Tomorrow is Sunday, there's yoga at 9:30, Instagram Live. So feel free to come along. And of course, we'll be sitting before that. So I'll see you then. Okay.